Hello friend, welcome you all to my channel. Today I'm going to show you that how you can colorize or enhance the color contrast of Disney plot or UMAP plot using the R script. Here you can see colorize Disney plot and UMAP plot, and you can see the difference between the FlowJo generated UMAP and R script generated UMAP, as well as FlowJo generated Disney plot R transform Disney plot, showing the expression of CD4 here. And in the UMAP here and here. So this looks much better than the FlowJo generated tSNE and UMAP plot. So today I'm going to show you how you can transform your tSNE plot, UMAP plot, as well as TRIMAP plot using the R script. So for this, you have to type Sydney cytometry / tSNE plot in the Google and search. You will get the link from the GitHub. Just open this. Here, click on the code and download the zip file. I have already downloaded, so I'm going to show you that. Here is the downloaded file, and I have already extracted the file, so I'm going to open this. They have given the any file and folder, but you can see here the PDF and the R script. These two files are very important, and if you open the PDF file, you can see that this is provided by the Sydney Cytometry Core facility in 2017. And if you scroll down, you can see they have provided each step how you can prepare your tSNE plot or transform your tSNE plot using the R script. And they have mentioned that please reference us if you found this script helpful. So if you are using this script in your data analysis, please reference them. And the second file is R script. If you open this, here you can see they have given all the command and information about how you have to use this script. So I will show you how you can use this script to transform your tSNE plot as well as UMAP plot. Before using the R script, we need data file from the FlowJo. So I'm going to show you that how you can transport the file of tSNE plot or UMAP plot of your flow cytometry experiment from the FlowJo software, so that you can use for the transformation of your tSNE plot or colorization of your tSNE plot as well as UMAP plot. Here I am showing my experiment in which I have two group like EC and VL day 0, and I have concatenated all the FCS file and export as trial 1f.fcs file. And here if I open this, can see I have grouped the concatenated file on the basis of the keyword that I have added, like type of sample you can add before concatenating your data, so that you can differentiate the your group like EC and VL day 0 in concatenated file, and run the tSNE and UMAP plot. If you change the axis, like for the tSNE 1 on the x-axis and the tSNE 2 on the y-axis, you can see the tSNE plot. And if you want to see the expression of any particular marker, just click here, and you can see here this is showing the expression of CD4 on the total sample. But if you go to here and change the sample like VL day 0, you can see the expression of VL day 0. And if you want to see the expression on the EC group as well, just duplicate here and you can see the expression by clicking here EC. So you can see the tSNE plot having the expression of CD4 on the VL day 0 group and the EC group. Likewise, if you want to see the UMAP, I run the tSNE and UMAP both the analysis on the same data. So if you go here on the axis, change the axis UMAP 1 x-axis and UMAP 2 on the y-axis, you can see the UMAP plot here on the day 0 group. And change the sample here, you can see the CD4 expression on the EC group. And if you want to see the expression of other marker, just click here and you can see the expression of of your required or choice of interest from here. Now I'm going to show you that how you can export the data file from the FlowJo software to transform your tSNE or UMAP plot using the R script. I'm selecting the VLD0 group here first. So you can export the group that you want to make transformation in your tSNE or UMAP plot. So I'm selecting VLD0 group. Go to the file and export. Click here on the export. And in the output format, you have to select the CSV channel value. This is very important. And here, select the destination folder. Include event, include all, and the parameter, select the custom set parameter. And this is very crucial step. You have to select your parameter that you want to make the tSNE plot and want to transfer using the R script. So select all your parameter, including the your UMAP and tSNE parameter. This is very important. You have to include this parameter. Maybe in your case, you have only UMAP or tSNE. Just select that one. I am deselecting the live parameter because I have included only the live cell in this analysis. And click here on OK. And in the advanced option, you can rename your exported file name. I am changing the name VLD0. And if you want to customize your name, just click here custom, edit, and remove like your file name and other things so that it have only the name that you have assigned here. And click here on the export. I have exported VLD0, and you can also export other group. Here you can see in my folder VLD0 CSV file is present, and if you open this, it has all the value of your parameter as well as the UMAP and tSNE parameter also. So we are going to use this CSV file to transform our tSNE plot or UMAP plot. Here you can see the GitHub downloaded folder. They have provided the tSNE plot R script. So if you open this, here you can see they have provided each and every step that you have to follow to transform your or colorize your tSNE or UMAP plot. They have specifically recommended this for only tSNE plot, but you can also use for the UMAP TriMAP plot to transform your data. So here they have provided the some detail. And from the step one, I'm going to show you that you need like ggplot to color ram these packages for running this script. So I have already downloaded all the script, but if you don't have, you have to download using this command. And after downloading the packages, you have to load these packages in your console so that you can analyze your data. So I'm going to load these packages. So just select all these packages and go to here, click on the run. You can see all the packages are loaded in my console window. The next step is to assign the color. So select the line and click here on the run button. In the global environment, you can see the jet colors function is present. And the next step is for the user input. So you have to assign your path, your folder. So the first step is to select the directory that you are going to use for your analysis. So for example, they have given the command like set word, user, tom, and desktop, and that this is by default. You have to change according to your folder. So if you remove the hash sign, you can see the now this command is active, and I'm going to change my username here. You can change according to your username, desktop, and my folder name is, I'm going to copy the name. This is my folder name that I have going to use for my analysis, and I have the exported data file here. So I'm going to set this directory as a working directory. Just select this, and you can also execute your command using the control and enter button. And after this, just use the following command that they have already provided. Select, click run. After get working directory, you need to use primary directory. Primary directory. You can see all the command is executed here, and my folder tSNE UMAP training is assigned as a primary directory. And after this, here you can see the create a list of file name of sample and check file names. So the next step is to assign your data file that we have exported from the FlowJo software. Here you can just copy the file name of your data file that you have exported. In my case, it is VLD0 and it is CSV file. And I'm going to assign the name here. And VLD0.csv because it is a CSV file, and select file and click here on the run. And also the next command. In the global environment, you can see VLD0 CSV file is present. And now follow all the other command that they have mention, like names. This command is to see the column name or the variable name in your data file. So you can see here in the console window, all the markers are available in this VLD0 CSV file, along with the UMAP and tSNE. So next step is plot X name and plot Y name. This is very important, and you have to rename your plot X and Y name according to the variable present in your exported data file. If you are going to transform your tSNE plot or UMAP plot, and you have both the variable in your data file, so you have to select the tSNE if you want to make the transform in tSNE. And you have to select the UMAP if you want to make the transformation in UMAP. So for X and Y name, you have to see the variable name here. Here you can see that tSNE.fcs1 and tSNE1.fcs2. So this is the X and this is the Y tSNE parameter. It always follow the same pattern. First will be the X and the second will be the Y. So just copy this X value of tSNE parameter and paste here in the script. And for the Y, just copy the second tSNE parameter here and paste here. And select both the line and click here the run button, and now follow all the command that is written here. Table combined.df numeric combined. I'm just entering the all the command that they have mentioned here. And here you can see on 110 line, this is the command to make the folder in the, your directory. And at the point of At the number of 112, you have to just click here on this arrow, and this will minimize all the command in one line, and just select here and wait to finish this red dot. And if you click here, like, and now you can execute all the command together. Just go on the run button and click here, and you can see this is working. And if you go to the your directory folder, here you can see the output folder that R script generated, and you can see it is making the tSNE plot for all the parameter that was present in my data. Here you can see the tSNE plot of VLDAO CD4 parameter. If you open this, you can see the expression of CD4 on this tSNE plot. And if you open the original tSNE plot that is generated in the FlowJo, this is the UMAP. I'm going to change the parameter for the tSNE FCS1 and tSNE by FCS2. So you can see this is the tSNE plot showing the expression of CD4 on FlowJo generated plot, and this is the R script file. You can see the difference. This looks much better than this one. And so in this way you can transform your tSNE plot or UMAP plot. You have to just, for the UMAP plot, you have to just change the like value here in the plot X and plot Y name. You have to select the value here like UMAP 1 and UMAP 2 for plot X and Y names, so that you can transform your UMAP in using this script. Use this R script to make your tSNE plot, UMAP plot, TriMAP plot to much better look and the better contrast. And I hope this may help you in your research. And if you want to know more about this, you can just comment. I will try to help you as much as possible. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.